You know what? I was a teenager in the 90s, so when I hear the word icebreakers, I think of those little mints that were on every commercial break.
Oh, right, right. I remember that. I'm older than you, though, so I don't think that I didn't have that as much.
Yeah,
I know.
That's probably it. Yeah.
Ice babies way more rhyme.
Yep, exactly.
So before we get any further, Nick, tell everybody about yourself.
Well, first, before I do that, I just want to say, Happy Rocktober!
Happy Rocktober! And thank you for being the voice of Rocktober for 3 years running.
That was a lot of fun, and I absolutely love doing it. So, my name is Nick. I work at NAMI Champlain Valley. I am a person who has struggled and still struggles with mental health issues and addiction, but I'm doing everything I can to get my life in order and to help as many people as possible because that helps me.
Exactly. And with you helping yourself, you quite often trickle down into the community and you help people like me, so I appreciate you.
Well, you know, self-care is community care, and community care is self-care.
I
really believe that. So hey, it is Rocktober or October. I know that this is your favorite month of the year, right?
It sure is.
Yep. I love this month because I really like the harvest season. I don't really know why, but food seems to taste better. The air is crisper and I sleep a lot deeper. And this is the time of year where I am mostly well and happy.
Me too. So, somewhat.
It's a fun time of year. And because I'm doing well, that got me thinking. And that is when I am doing well, I tend to use that as a good time to reach out and check on the people in my life. Does that make sense?
It does. And, you know, so for me is like, I love this month and I find this month to be hard for me. So I'm finding a lot of my people are reaching out to me. Whereas some days I am the one that's reaching out to other people. I'm feeling the benefit of being reached out to this month. So for everyone who's breaking the ice with me, I appreciate it.
Oh, perfect. Yeah, good. And, you know, I mean, reaching out is it can be weird. It can be awkward. And it's not always something that I've been good at. I still find it difficult from time to time, but I'm better than I used to be. Because, you know, I used to convince myself that I was probably bothering the person that I was reaching out to, or I'd be so concerned and tripped up with the idea that I might say something that came across as disingenuous, like, hey, how's it going? Or what's up? Or how are you? You know, we have those things. We say things like, how's it going? Or what's up? Or how you doing? But we really don't want a detailed response.
Right.
Does that make sense?
It does.
Yeah. So after years of experience and quite a bit of research, I've learned a couple of things. But one thing I've learned is I've learned that a lot of people will tell you what they think you want to hear rather than talk about their struggles. And this might be for a couple of reasons. One, they might want to protect you, or maybe they just want to keep things simple. So here's an example. Amanda, I want you to ask how I'm doing.
How you doing today, Nick?
Oh, I'm good. I'm good. Things are good. See what I mean?
Yeah, like, and I would say, because I can't say the word on the air, I'd be like, that's BS. What's really going on?
Right, exactly. But that's because you know me well, and you know, you probably know a few of my tells, but we probably all have people in our lives where when we say, what's up or how's it going, we really just would rather have a, oh, you good? You're good? Okay, thumbs up? All right, great.
Yes.
but if your intention is to check in with them and offer them help if they need it, you will probably need to break the ice. And the idea is to start a small conversation so that they break down their defenses a little and trust you enough to tell you what is really going on. So after years of experience, research and training in theater improvisation, I have come up with a few tips and tricks when it comes to engaging and connecting with people.
Excellent.
Yes. Now, I have dozens of these, but I chose four icebreakers that I believe with a little practice and a lot of intention, anyone can use these when trying to reach out to a friend or a loved one. And before I get into this, I just want to say that I'm not suggesting that you ever trick anyone, These icebreakers are all about forming a connection with the intention of making awkward conversations less awkward.
Mm.
And also, you need to be willing to either help this person with whatever they need or help them find the resources that they need. I need to put forth this idea that people need to understand that it's 100% okay to let the person that you're helping know that you do not know how to help them, but you will share the burden with them and maybe lighten the load by doing a little research and a lot of listening. Mm. Does that make sense?
Sure does.
Okay. So Amanda and listeners in the Zebrahood, if you are ready, here are four icebreakers that will hopefully help you connect with people that you are concerned about. So before I jump into this, I just want to say you can use these icebreakers in a text or over the phone or in person, but I'm just going to say I personally reach out a lot more via text because it's easier for me, it's less awkward. But the idea is to begin a conversation and then segue into asking them how they are doing sincerely. Mm-hmm. So are you ready for number one?
I am.
All right. Icebreaker number one, and this is silly, but you can ask them if they've watched that new movie or that new show or that new season of that show on whatever popular streaming service that you use, like Netflix or Hulu or whatever. Now, this works in a couple of ways. One, if they've seen it, they can tell you what they thought of it. Two, if they have not seen it, you can tell them why you think they would like it or not like it. Or if maybe both of you haven't seen it, you can talk about why you haven't seen it yet. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Cool. It's an icebreaker. It just opens up the conversation. So here's icebreaker number two, and that is ask their advice about something that's like light in subject. So if you say something like, hey, I was thinking of trying the new keto diet, or I was thinking of trying the new broccoli diet or something, or hey, I was thinking about buying that brand new video game. It really doesn't matter what you talk about, just be sincere. And I would suggest maybe avoiding religion and politics.
Yeah, because those are things that can bring like a lot of emotion out in people.
Right. But if you ask advice, especially about something that's kind of superficial or light, you can, it kind of gets the ball rolling and then you can dig into some deeper stuff. So I've got two more icebreakers and they're a lot heavier, but I think they're easier to do than just, really deep diving. And that is icebreaker number three is ask them about a mutual friend or one of their family members. So start the conversation with, hey, have you heard from or seen Sharon lately? Or you could say something along the lines of, hey, I saw that your brother wasn't feeling well on Facebook. How's he doing? You know, because you're kind of diverting the conversation into something, a mutual interest that the two of you share. And that can actually lead on you checking in on someone else or giving the person that you're talking to the kind of the courage or the reminder to check on that other person. And then at that time, you can segue into, oh, but hey, you tell me how you're doing first. So what, you know what I mean?
Yeah, you can make it takes the burden off of them at first and maybe makes them a bit more comfortable to talk.
Exactly. So, and comfort is what this is all about. If you're like me, you're almost never going to be comfortable, but things can be easier when you get a conversation started. So icebreaker number four, and this is the last one that I have, is a great icebreaker is to reach out to somebody and ask them for help. Now, just make sure to remind them why you value their help, and try not to make them feel obligated. Now, this is something that is probably a little more advanced and may require a little more work, but something that I have learned over the years about people who struggle, they love to help and be helpful because being needed and appreciated feels really good. And when you are of service, it gives you kind of a break from your struggles and it gives you something to focus on. And after you've talked about that thing that you need help with, it's a really great time for you to kind of, it's that give and take. And then you can go, oh, okay, well, you know, hey, enough about me. How about you? How was that? that, how's that thing that you were talking about? Or how's that, you know, how are you with that X, Y, and Z?
Yeah, that's good. That you know, it's helpful to have a plan, to have these things in your back pocket.
It is. And you know, it seems like it's just basic conversation that I'm talking about, but unless you practice these and really kind of have intention behind them, you might slip into the, oh, okay, they really don't want to talk about it. And what's really great is you can try one of these icebreakers, and if they don't really connect, try another icebreaker. Really work it, you know?
Yeah.
And I will suggest also, if you reach out to somebody and they're not really that responsive, or you just don't feel like you're connecting, give it a little time. Follow up the following day and try a different thing, you know? Maybe you are annoying them. Who knows? But you want to help and you want to reach out to somebody. If somebody was struggling, they're going to appreciate you taking a little time out of your life and giving them some attention. So now we've talked about resources on the show several times. So if you want to learn more about local and national resources, please go ahead and check out our past conversations on the MHSG.org or by going to and looking for the Mental Health Survival Guide on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, or Tumblr. Or you can send me an email. My email is nick@nami-cd.org.
Awesome. Well, Nick, as always, thank you very much, and I'll let you take us out of this, but stay on the line for me, though, okay?
Oh, yeah, no problem. And Amanda and all listeners, take care of yourselves so you are able to take care of others, because we all know that survival is so much more than just staying alive.
Thanks, Nick.